We often hear the word percentage or percent. People say that they scored, say for example, 80% in some exam. Or somebody says that the gas price went up by 10%. So what does this word percent or percentage mean? Percent can be written as per cent. Cent means 100. Where have we heard this word cent as 100? In century. When we say century, century means 100. So when somebody says percent, that means out of 100 equal parts. And this is the sign to show that the number means a percentage. Now what does it mean by out of 100 equal parts? Let's look at this picture. Now there is this big square, and this big square is divided into 10 rows and 10 columns. That means this big square is divided into 100 small squares that are 100 equal parts. So out of these 100 equal parts, if these two parts are colored, then I would say that 2% of the big square is colored. What if I color 4 parts? Then we can say that 4% of the big square is colored. If I color the whole first row, now how many small squares are there in the first row? 10 squares are there. So if I color the whole row, then we can say that 10% of the big square is colored. If I color 5 such rows, that means I would color 50 parts, that would be 50%. And if I color everything, that means I have colored all the 100 parts, so it would be 100%. Or 100% can also be called as one whole. Now let's go back to this 10% picture. Right, I have this big square where the first row is colored, that means the 10% of the square is colored. Now I take exactly another picture like this and put right next to this one. So it will look like this. So now previously I had 10 small squares colored. Now I have 20 small squares colored. So is this now 10% or is it 20% because I have 20 squares colored? Now when I say that I have 20 squares colored, are those 20 squares out of 100? No. Now in this picture the total number of squares are 200 because it is doubled. So the 20 squares that are colored, are those are out of 200. So I can say that 20 out of 200 is same as 10 out of 100. Therefore, this is still 10%. So I can still say that 10% of my picture is colored. Now let's look at this picture. 50% of the square is colored here. Now when I look at a particular picture and I color or select part of it, and when I represent that in a number, does that remind you of something? Have we done something like this somewhere else? Yes, we have done the same thing for fractions. Now what do we do? If I have to write the colored area in terms of fraction, how do I write that? I write that as 50 over 100. Why? Because out of 100, 50 squares are colored, the small squares. And if you convert that to lowest term, it would be 1 over 2 or 1 half. That means I can write the percentage in terms of a fraction also. Let's see some more examples. Now I have some more percentages here. 25, 75 and 10. So 25 would be 25 over 100, which is equal to 1 over 4 or 1 quarter. That means 25% is equal to 1 quarter. 75% would be 75 over 100 is equal to 3 over 4 or 3 quarters. That means 75% is equal to 3 quarters. 10% would be 10 over 100, which is equal to 1 over 10, which is equal to 1 tenth. That means 10% is 1 tenth of the area. So, what do we see here? We see that percentages can be written as fractions. And it works other way around also. Fractions can also be written as percentages. More about this we will see in the next video.